So yesterday we discussed about DFA, right? So what was DFA? DFA is usually a five tuple system and it has five components. That's why we say five tuple system. You have a possible number of states, then whatever the input symbol, basically the alphabet on which this machine is going to run. Then the transition functions for the states, you have final states, and at the end you have the start state, right? Q0. So this is the five components for any DFA machine. Now, for this machine, basically we saw few examples. And the question that I asked in the class for you to do, how many of you were able to do? Means, is there anyone who was able to do it by himself without taking help from somewhere else? Anyone who was able to solve it? No one? Anyways, so the question was something very simple. It was that, I hope you remember the question. It was that if for L equals to, so X belongs to sigma star for alphabet set 0, 1, such that decimal value of X is divisible. Okay, right. So, how we solve it? That is the question. So, can you tell that how many possible sets will be there? How many feasible sets or feasible states are required to do it? Two are sufficient, three, four, five, how many? Okay, someone says four. Good. Okay, four is a good number, but let me say that I can do it by three only. So, to understand and to solve it, yes, correct, three. So, to understand and to make a DFA for it, I think the basic importance is that we understand how many states will be sufficient to really do it. So, for any decimal value that is divisible by 3, what all possibilities are there? So, if I have to write in general, so I can write x equals to, in decimal form, either it will be 3y type or it can be 3y plus 1 type or x can be 3y plus 2 type after conversion. Whatever the string you pick, you will have three different possibilities, right? For a value of x once you convert into decimal. So it says that it is actually divisible by 3. This says that it is one more than multiple of 3. It says 2. Basically, modulo 2, modulo 1, and this is modulo 0. Means divisible. Exactly, that's what is required, nothing more than that. So if I have to draw, I can draw a state writing as 3y. I can draw another state writing as 3y plus 1, and I can draw another state as 3y plus 2. Right. Now, starting with now Okay, Anmol said that 1 4 times 0 1 is also true, so it should have 6 states. Yes. See, for a given language, there can be different possible DFAs. I think yesterday someone asked that, can there be multiple possible machines for the same language? And the answer is yes. But there is some way to find out the smallest one. Certainly, we'll be learning that too. Right. So all possibilities are there. You can design a large machine for the same language. One can design a very efficient one. I'm just telling you what logic one should think before starting. Certainly, you can have a different logic for implementing the same problem. Right. Okay. So for I think Dhruv asked a very interesting important question, that if it is null string, what should be. So certainly we have to take care of that. But before really going into that, let's understand what all states the machine will be when it is at some intermediate point. For the beginning, you can always design the start state and all if it requires add more states. But I think for designing a machine for this problem, certainly when you are processing any binary string, so if this is a binary string and you are processing it bit by bit. So once you have read here, you are moving to here. So from moving from left to right, when you are moving and reading the string, certainly at this point of time, whatever you have read so far, that you have to always be ready with the answer, and that's what is the state. So state always tells you that whatever the string you have read so far, as per the language, where does it stand? Are you ready to accept X if the string finishes here? So that when you reach at this point of time and read the last symbol, then the state itself is going to make the decision for you. Right? That is the main objective. Because state contains the information that whatever the string you have processed so far, whether I should accept or reject, you can store more information for basically understanding in what particular state you are. So in this case, I am able to figure it out. Okay, there are three different type of states. There is a modulo 0, modulo 1, modulo 2 possibilities. Now, if there is any binary string B, right? So basically you are in some given state. If it is B and if you add a 0 after it, and if there was a binary string B and you add a 1 after it, let's try to understand what happens to its decimal side. So this is the binary side and this is the decimal side, right? So let's say that D is the decimal value of B, right? So if D is the decimal value of B, when you write B0, what does it mean? So the value of B0, when you try to convert in decimal, actually you will realize that it becomes 2D. And B with appended 1 ahead, what it does? It does 2D plus 1. I think it's a very basic, you might be really able to understand this point. Because what happens, every single bit in the B binary string gets shifted left by 1. So every single bit gets multiplied by 2 extra. And then 0 means the initial bit, the least significant bit is 0. That means you are not adding anything, just multiplying by 2. But if it is 1, so apart from shifting everything by 2, by multiplying by 2, another 1 is added. I think that is very trivial. So we are going to use exactly this simple logic to really design our machine. We say that at any point of time, whatever the string you have processed, if it was of the type 3y, what does it mean? That so far whatever you have processed, it is divisible by 3. Then if you add a 0, where will you go? So if I am at 3y type and I add a 0, where will I go? 3y means divisible by 3. If you add a 0, where should I go? Should I remain? So basically what I'm asking, that if you have a decimal number, right, a binary number whose decimal representation is divisible by 3, if you append a 0 in the right hand side, what type of decimal number you will be getting?
Say mistake.
Good.
Why say mistake? I think you all will be agree that it's just multiplication of 2, and anyway it was divisible by 3, so it will remain divisible by 3.
Good.
So all right answers. So for value of 0, I should have a self loop. At 1, where should I go? At 1, it will become 3 into 2, 6y plus 1. And 6y plus 1 is certainly of the type 3y, right? Because there is a multiple of 3. So at 1, it will be going from here to this place. Now, for this, all possible inputs are covered. Let's go to next state and try to understand what all possible inputs will be there. For value of 0, because our machine is based on this alphabet, so we have to, from every state, we have to take all possible inputs. From 3y plus 1 at 0, where will I go? We will be actually going for 0, we will be moving to this place. Why? Because 3y plus 1 times 2, it will become 6y plus 2. 6y is divisible by 3, so it is of a type of 3y, so it is 3y plus 2 type. Now, for 1, where will you go? 3y plus 1 at 1, what will happen? Good, very good. So 3y, all correct answers. 3y plus 1 at 1, you will be able to return back to 3y. Reason, I think it is 2 times 3y, it's 6y plus 2 plus another 1. So 6y plus 3, actually it is 3 times 2y plus 1. Altogether, you are getting 3 times y type, y dash type. 3y plus 2, if you have a 1, you will realize that you are going back to this place, because it becomes 6y plus 4, and at 0 it remains, at 1 it goes, at 0 it goes here, at 1 it will remain at the same place. Correct. So at 0, it is going to 3y plus 1. Why? Because it becomes 6y plus 4, which is actually, once you take the modulo, you will be getting 1. Correct. And for value of 3 we have designed for 3 states, but now we have to understand what is our final state and what is actually the start state. We have designed the states, the transitions and everything. What will be the final state as per our language? 3y is the correct final state, right? And once you have understood that, now next part comes to say what is the start state. So in the beginning, now here is the crux. For epsilon, where you go? We don't go anywhere, right? Epsilon, decimal value of epsilon is undefined. So therefore, you cannot start from any of these states, because they do not represent the correct version. So you have to create another start state. And you have to say at epsilon you are at this particular point. Correct. Now, this is start state. So let me give name Q0. Now from Q0 at 0, where will I go? Once you get a 0, you will be moving to which state? Good. So you will be moving to 3y, because it is divisible by 0, divisible by 3. And at 1, you will be going from here to this place. Right. So this is my start state. At 0 it goes here, at 1 it goes here. So now this is the complete machine. So those who gave the answer as 4 was correct. But see, this state that at 0 you are going to this point, at 1 you are moving to this point, that was essential in this case because we were saying that decimal value of x is divisible by 3. At place of that, when you are talking about length, so even epsilon has some one of the states, it is tackled. So in that case, it sometimes is not required to add extra state. So see, the crux of the functioning of the machine lies here, right? Once machine took off from the start state, it never goes back to the start state. All the logic part is in this box. If you understand that, this is just that you are able to tackle epsilon correctly. That's all. After epsilon is tackled, you don't need to go back to this state. Rest everything is here. Is that clear? Okay, so let's take another answer is 4, Harsh. So total 4 states, not 3. So for this particular language, 4 states are required. Yeah. Okay, let's take another quick example of a DFS. So let's take the language that x belongs to 0, 1 star, such that x starts with 0, 1, 1. Right. So I think this is a very simple DFA that you have to design for it, and it's very easy. You start from the start state. In the beginning, if you are getting a 1, what happens? If you get a 0, you are reaching to a more hopeful state, right? And if you get a 1, so this is Q0. If you get a 1, what happens? Can anyone tell? If I get a 1 from the start state, what should happen? Terminate the execution altogether. Correct. Remaining there will not help because, see, if you are saying that your string starts with 0, 1, 1. So 0, 1, 1 and then something, right? This is your string type. And 1, if you received as the first, in that case, what will happen? You can never reach to any accepting state. So there is a concept of something called a dead state. Dead state is basically a state where once you enter, for all possible upcoming zeros or ones, you remain in the same state. You never come out. There is no outgoing link from dead state. So this state is specifically used whenever you feel that once, if this particular event occurred, then you can never accept this string in the language, right? So once you realize that it is starting with 1, you said that, okay, you go to dead state. Sorry, we cannot accept, right? But if you got a 0, you are still hopeful that next one is 1. If from this state, if you get a 1, so you become more hopeful that yes, I'm moving in the right direction. Oh, will be coming unmoved. Just wait a second. So in this case, if you are and from this particular state, if you get a 0, what happens? From state number 2, so let's give 1 to Q1, Q0. Okay, I have already given Q0, so let me give it number Q1, Q2, and let's give it QD. So from Q1, when you gonna get a 0, what happens? Again, it says that your string starts with 00, not by 011. So again, from this, again at 0, you should be coming back to dead state because there is no hope. You have lost all hopes, even if it starts with 00. From this, if you get a 1, what happens? you reach to this final state, right? Because it, whatever you have realized, 0, 1, 1, the string has followed that it started with 0, 1, 1, so you reach to this QF as the final state. But if you got a 0 at this point, so it is saying your string starts with 0, 1, 0, so you should be going back to dead state. Now, so from the first state you have already figured out the transition for 0, figured out the transition for 1, right? From the second state Q1 you have already figured out for 1 and 0, for dead state also you have figured out, only the QF state is remaining. Now let's see what happens for QF. So QF at 0, where should I go? Good. So for 0 or 1 you will remain in the same state, because you are really very very happy that now whatever comes after it, I don't care, right? It's like in a series of matches already, of series of 7 matches, the first 4 matches India already won. So whatever is the outcome of the remaining matches, it doesn't matter. Already India won the series, right? So it is exactly like that. You have already achieved the goal once you reached in this state. Whatever comes after 0, 1, 1, whatever string X here, it doesn't matter, it will be acceptable on this machine. Because 0, 1, 1, you are really happy. Right. So there is a question by Samad saying, can't we do like Q0 goes to Q0 if input is 1? Why making a dead state? See, okay, let's take this alternative that at I have drawn for 1 going this place, right? Remain in the same. Now what happens? And you don't go here, assuming that this is not happening. So what is happening? If that is the possibility, you will realize that for any number of 1s in the beginning and then 0, 1, 1 and X, it is acceptable on the machine. Yes or no? Because all these ones that you have written, any number of ones, so I am saying any number of ones are there, it will keep remaining in the start state. It is not losing hope. While processing the first few, already you have lost the hope. So that's why it is very important that every input symbol should be tackled really properly. That it should not let you, so that's what happened. See, this is a counter string, right? So this is a counter string for this machine that Samarth suggested previously, that why can't we have 1 on the start state itself? Because if you take this string on this machine, what happens? It is acceptable. But this particular string does not belong to the language. So if you remember, for a counter string I told you 2 criteria. Whenever you run a string and it is reaching to accepting a state, it should be in the language. Whenever you are taking a string which is not taking you to this final state, it should not be in the language. So you should not have any counter string when you are designing a machine. And the same should be that given a machine, if you are asked to tell the language, the same criteria should be matched. So usually what happens in exams or quizzes, when I ask, given a language L, design a machine D. Once you design a machine D, I will try to find a counter string for this D. And if I am able to find a counter string for D, you fetch 0 marks out of whatever is the score. So that is the main concept. You should really mark it. If I am able to detect a counter string for your design machine, your machine is incorrect and you should be fetching 0 marks for it. Okay, so okay, so I think you are clear with this. I just wanted to give you a concept of dead state. Let's go back to further concepts. So in the DFA, if you realize the processing, let me just go back to the previous DFA and give you how DFA actually processes. So if you see, let's take the string 0110, right? So when you start processing this, what happens? You were at Q0, you received input 0, you went to state Q1, you received 1, you went to state Q2, you received input 1, you went to state QF, and after that you got a 0, you remained in the same state, QF. And because the state that you reached after processing the last input symbol is one of the final states, therefore this string is acceptable to me, right? So in general, if I have to write a computation that is acceptable for a machine, for a DFA, so how I will be writing? So I'll be writing that, let D be a DFA and W is a string in sigma star, right? So W is accepted by D if number one condition is that, what are conditions are required? So number one condition is that, and yes, before that, remember that this D is actually a 5-tuple system. So you have Q, you have respective sigma, delta, F, Q0. And you are saying that when you run this W, so when you run D for W, you get a sequence of, so let's say W is actually A1, A2 up to AN, N symbols are there. When you process machine D on for W, it takes you for a sequence of a state starting from R0, R1 up to Rn plus 1. So there will be N plus 1 states in the sequence when you are processing for this. And this looks like that you are starting with R0. You are fetching A0, you are going to R1, you are processing A1, so sorry, starting with A1, then A2, you are going to R2, and likewise, so this will not be there. So finally, this will take you, after processing AN, you will reach back to Rn, right? R0 to Rn. So in this case, three condition has to be met for the sequence. Whenever you run a string on a machine and you say that this string is acceptable, only if three conditions are met. Condition 1, condition 2, condition 3. One is that R0 should be actually Q0. That is very crucial, that you are starting from the start state, the execution, the simulation of the string. The first symbol should be processed from the first state, Q0 start state. Next is that for every delta Ri, right? And you have Ai plus 1, where should you be reaching? You should be reaching to Ri plus 1. So this is a transition already available in your transition function of the machine. And the third is that your Rn should be one of the final states. So if these three conditions are met, you say that the string is acceptable. So just mathematically I am representing what when you say that a string is accepted by machine, that if it starts from the start state, once you are processing on the transition, it should be following the transitions of the DFA and you should be ending up in one of the final states. Correct. So it is just mathematically representing what logically we understood. Okay. So let's go further. So there is something called extended transition function. What do we mean by extended transition function? So if you remember, delta was a function that was mapping q cross sigma to q, right? Now here we are defining another transition function, delta cap, that takes you from q cross sigma star to q. I think if you are able to follow the mathematics here, it's very trivial. What I'm trying to say, it just says that here when you were seeing at the transition function, it was saying delta at some state q for a symbol a, it was going to p, right? Now here it will look like for a state q, some string you are processing and it is going to some state p for w equals to a1, a2 up to some a. That is the difference. So it is extended transition function. This transition function was just mapping that after a state q, if you read a, you go to p. But this extended transition function says that if you were at a state q, you process the string w, you will be ending up in state p. So it is just and definition of this is available as an inductive definition. So the basic step, if I have to define for delta cap, so it is very trivial that delta cap for any state with epsilon is remaining in the same state. And then the inductive step is, if you try to find the induction, so delta cap for q xa will be equals to delta of delta cap for q x a, right? So try understanding that this is a string w. So w is, you can break the w as if w is a1, a2 up to last symbol is a, so this part you are marking as x. So you are saying that w can be written as xa. In that case, delta cap for qw will be actually taking the transition from the state on symbol a, where you will end up when you have started from q and you already have considered x. So it is, if I have to represent it in the state form, it's like this is your q. This is what you achieve after processing x. So you end up in this temporary state this, and once you take a move a, you are ending up at this state p. So the result of delta cap qxa will be p. Why it is? Because you will be considering that the delta cap value of q on x, whatever you are achieving, you take a from there and you will be ending up in p. So it is just an inductive definition. We will not be using this extended transition function anywhere. It is just for understanding that transition function is for one single symbol. Extended transition function, let us realize that for processing a substring or a string, where it's a fast forward, right? It considers more than one symbol string and from a given state where you end up. So this helps us define what is language of a machine, right? So if I have to write that let's say that D is a DFA. So what is language of a DFA? What is language of a DFA? Basically, if L of D. So L of D is actually set of all strings that D accepts. What is language of D? It is set of all strings that D accepts, right? Means all possible strings that can take you from start state to final state. All strings you keep in the set, and that set is the language of D. So if I have to really mathematically define this set, I can write using this extended transition function. How I can write that L of D is equals to W, right? Such that delta cap for Q0 W is actually an element of F. What I am saying that whenever you start from a state Q0, Q0 is the start state, and you process a string, if the extended transition function, so this is Q0, whenever you process this W, okay, not after several steps, when you are processing W, you end up in this state P, right? And this is the start state. So if P belongs to F, certainly you say that W is acceptable. So this is how we define the language of a machine. So I hope it's clear to all of you, right? Is there any question? No. A good question. So it is belongs to F, because so far we haven't seen a language or a DFA where multiple states are final state, right? But there might be machine where multiple states can be final state. So in that case, you will say that belongs to F, because F can be multiple final states. It may be QF1, QF2, and likewise, right? So in that case, you have to say that one, wherever you are reaching, it is one of the final states. You don't say it is the final state. That is the difference. So if you have practiced or you tried practicing, if you take this language, let me quickly draw a DFA for you so that you also understand that. So if X belongs to 0, 1 star, such that X, so if I have to write X has odd number of zeros or even number of ones, right? So X has odd number of zeros or even number of ones. So now there are two different possible constraints. So if I have to design, basically there will be four states, possible states. Quickly I am doing, so try to stick with the thing. So four possibilities I am writing, that zeros are even, ones are even, here zeros are odd, ones are even, here zeros are even, ones are odd, and here zeros are odd and ones are odd, right? So these are all possibilities for a binary string, right? When you calculate the number of zeros and number of ones, this is the total all possibilities that you can have. Four possible things. What will be the start state? When you have nothing, empty, so Number of zeros and ones are 0, 0 and both are even. So this is your start state, right? Now, when it is zeros are even and ones are even, when you receive a zero, what happens? One remains unchanged, while the zeros will go where? At a zero, you will be moving, right? So for this, anyway, you can create the transition diagram. I will not go in detail of that. Just to answer what Rhodes asked, right? So if you try to realize what will be the final state. So x has odd number of zeros. So odd number of zeros are at these two places. So this will become final state. Even number of ones. So it is here and even number of ones are here. So all these three states are final state except this one. Because this state, it has even number of zeros and odd number of ones. So apart from this, three states are final. So when you try to write this, Q has four states. F has actually three of them. So I hope it's clear, right? Anything else? So try drawing the transition diagram. I have not drawn it. Anything else? Okay. So BFAs are done. I think we have to do a lot of practice. We need to fix a slot for practice session. I think that will be very helpful for you to really understand different ways, different types of DFAs and all that. Let's quickly jump to another machine which is looks more advanced than DFAs. So what were DFAs actually? DFAs were deterministic finite automaton. Our constraint was, whenever you are designing a DFA, what was the constraint? It was that from every state, for every input, you should be having some arrow, right? Whether it remains in the same state or not, but you have to define for 0 where does it go, for 1 where does it go. So your machine is incomplete if you have missed some transition. So once you find all possible states for a machine, for every such state you have to define for all possible input symbol where do you go. Maybe individual arrows might be taking you to different states, or you might be remaining in the same state, right? Now there is another machine called NFA. Here it is called non-deterministic. So it is a non-deterministic finite automata. What interesting property does it have? It actually relaxes that particular condition. So DFA, we said that for a given Q and A, it is going to a P for sure. You have to define this for every Q, for every possible A, you have to define a state where it ends up. In NFA, you are relaxing this situation. You relax. So if I have to define, apart from other, so NFA also is a 4-5 component system. Q, sigma, delta, let me write delta N here, F, Q0. All the components are same except this delta N. When you were writing delta D for DFA, what it was doing? It was taking you from Q cross sigma to Q. Here, this does the following. Q cross sigma, it goes to P of Q. What is P of Q? It's a power set of Q. Means, for a given state Q and an input symbol A, Now the answer is not a state. It goes from a possible number of states. It can go to several states for a given input. Or even it might not go anywhere. It's like it is not moving. So you don't need to define every single transition for all possible inputs on a given state. And for a single symbol from a given state, it can go to multiple states at the same time. So it's a power given to this machine that it is able to really say that on a given input, I can do all these possibilities, these many different states I can go. Actually, in a non-determinism way, it also reaches to those states and computes. You can have a bit kind of correlation with this guy, Dr. Strange, right? So he was in all possible possibilities, he was checking that for a given moment, if I take this move, so this is going to happen for this, like Sherlock Holmes and several. So they see all possibilities for a given input. If I do this, I may go to this possibilities. If I take this direction, I'll be going this possible way. So it is the non-deterministic power in some sense, not exactly, but just to digest this non-determinism. So it is like you are not very clear that it's like you were in 12th. Your non-determinism is that once you pass 12th with more than 80%, what you will do? If you are deterministic, you will say that I will sit for JE for sure, right? Or I will go for engineering. But for a non-deterministic person, it will be like, okay, I can go for engineering or also try for medical because I had a biology, or maybe I will take a commerce. I have several possibilities. So for the result of passing 12th as an input, I have multiple states to go. But for a deterministic student, he is clear that, or she is clear that, if I pass 12th, I have to go to the engineering state for as a next career, right? Or learning. Okay, let's try to understand from the language perspective and design a machine, then I think it will make more sense to us. Non-determinism actually is a power of guessing. So let's take one example and then I think it will be more clear. So extended transition functions, temporary states are counted? No, actually for extended transition function, there is no concept of the intermediate states or something like that. Extended transition function is just a concept to help you mathematically write what will be the language, and it will help you do some of the proofs for based on the induction. So inductive step, when you are doing induction, the simple transition function that we define in a machine, it just allows you to move symbol by symbol. But if you want to quickly move for a string or something, so it is just a mathematical extension of the transition function that allows you to really make a leap of symbols at once. And you say that I was in this state after processing these symbols. You don't actually really consider what states you went through at the intermediate level. You just realize that what is the final state. So for all the proofs that you'll be reading in the book, that comes as a handy tool, but we don't consider the intermediate states. It doesn't matter. Okay, so coming back to NFA, let's say the language is let's take L equals to X belongs to 0, 1 star, such that X ends with 0, 1, 1. Right? This is a language. If I have to design a DFA for it, how does it look like anyway? That is exercise you should be doing. But if I have to design an NFA for it, it is much trivial. I don't have to worry about all transitions, everything. I just have to say that this is my start state. If I get a 0, I become a more hopeful that it is ending. I get a 1, I get a 1, and this is my final state. Now this is the end. In beginning, I can have any string possibilities. Done. My machine is done. Over. Why it is over? For that, we need to understand when an NFA accepts. Right. If I have to design a DFA for it, how I will be designing? I have a start state. Correct? So, ends with 011. How you gonna design a DFA for it? If you remember, I'm at this, if I get a 0, I am more hopeful. If I get a 1, I am more hopeful. If I get another 1, I am very hopeful and happy that I have reached at this state. But see, the backbone looks very similar for NFA and DFA for this case. But the interesting change that comes here is that if you are at this state and you get a 1, that means your hope is not increasing, you remain in the same state. If you are at this state, you get a 0. What happens? Certainly, you remain in the same state. If you get a 1 after this, you are going here, but if you get a 0, you have to return back to this state. And at this state, basically, if I give the number as Q0, Q1, Q2, and Q3. So when you are at Q3 and you get a 0, where will you go? At 0, you will be returning back to state Q1. At 1, you will be doing what? You will lose all hopes. Because you got 0, 1, 1, 1, 3 ones. So certainly you cannot end with 011. So you'll be returning back to the start state. So I hope you can see the clear difference between these two machines. This is your NFA. This is your DFA. Before really understanding that they are doing the same thing, we have to understand the difference between how DFA accepts a string and how NFA accepts a string. Okay, Anmol asked a question that it was not very clear what NFA is. Let me just explain you. So the basic concept is, see, in the DFA, if you see the difference here, for every single state, what we did, for 0 and 1, we have a transition for every state. But in NFA, we are not really restricting this constraint. Again, if you see in this below machine, DFA, we are saying that for 1, you will be going to just one state. But if you see here, if I give the numbering as Q4, Q5, Q6, Q7, you see at Q4, for a 0, I am remaining at Q4. And I'm also going at Q5. So if you write the delta N for Q4 at 0, you are actually going to Q4 and Q5 both. I think that might make some clarity in your mind that for NFA, you have the possibility to go. Maybe you can go to all states for a given input. That is a feasibility, right? Because if you really just go back to this and see, the transition function here allows you to pick any set from the power set of all possible states. So you can pick all states, you can pick a subset of states for a given symbol and a state. That is the NFA. And it can also pick 5. 5 means not going anywhere. Right? So, when you say P of Q, it is basically, in the extreme case, you are picking all Q, the whole set, or you might be picking a subset of Q, or also you might be picking phi, means nothing. You are not going anywhere. Okay, there is a question that what happens after reaching Q6 and getting 0. So Q6 at 0 doesn't do anything. If you get a 0 at Q6, you will understand once I explain the branch. Let me just explain you the processing. Okay, let's take an input and see how it processes on these two different machines. So if I take the input as 1011. So now I am starting from Q0. This is my 1, then I have 0, then I have 1, then I have 1. 4 different input symbols. For my DFA, from Q0 I will be making a transition at 12, which means I will be going to Q0 itself. For a 0, I will be taking a transition to Q1. Then at 1, I will be going to Q2. And at 1, I will be going to Q3. So this is my processing diagram, right, for the string 1011 on DFA. Now let's see the same thing for NFA. So when I am starting with, let's pick the same 1011 for NFA. So I am starting with Q4 here. When I get a 1, what I will do for Q4? Q4 at 1, it moves to Q4 itself. Q4 at 0, it moves to Q5. At Q6, at 1 it moves to Q6, and finally at 1 it goes to Q7. So here you see the processing of DFA and NFA looks very similar, so there is no difference, right? And because here I said that Q7 is this final state and here Q3 is the final state, so the string is accepted on both the machines, so both the machine accept this string. But if I change the string, right, so let us change the string a bit. Let us pick a different string. So I am going few steps back and I am changing the string to this one, 00011. Now for 00011, how DFA will be acting? DFA will say start from Q0, you go to Q1 for a 0, for next 0 you go to, you remain in Q1, for next 0 you remain in Q1, for next 1 you go to Q2, for next 1 you go to Q3. It's a sequential processing, as you can see, right? But for the NFA, try looking what is happening. For Q4, I'm at state Q4, right? This is the start state. When I get a 0, what happens? Q4 at 0, you will realize that this is what is the transition. So when you are at a state Q4 and you are getting the input 0, you are not going to one state, you are going to two different possible states. Which two? Q4 and Q5. So now it's not a sequential processing, but a branching happens here. So Q4 at 0, you will be going to Q4 itself and Q5. Next 0, Q4 again, you will be further going to Q4 and Q5. But for Q5 at 0, what happens? Q5 at 0, if you realize there is no transition, that means this branch terminates at this point. It is not moving ahead. Right? You don't get any, you are not able to process any input further. Now, two branches were able to, so you were able to still get two branches at this point of time. So again, I have to go back further and process the rest. Q4 again at 0, where will you go? Q4 at 0, you will still go at Q4 and Q5. And for this Q5, the same result. This is terminating here. For this Q4 at 1, you remain in the same state, right? Q4 at 1, you are remaining at Q4. Q5 at 1, what is happening? You are going to Q6. Q4 at 1, you are still remaining in the same state, Q4. Q6 at 1, you are reaching to Q7. So this is the processing tree of NFA. This is the processing tree of processing of DFA. So DFA, it's a sequential processing for a string. So you always have a sequence of states when you are running. But in case of NFA, you get actually a tree structure, tree of states, basically where branches are occurring based on the states. Now, here you are reaching at Q3. So you say that this string is still acceptable because Q3 is one of the final state. But what about this one? Because in this case, this one is the final state. So good. So one branch, that once you start from the start state and able to process the whole input, you are able to reach to one of the accepting state. So this branch is called accepting branch, right? So accepting branch. And this is a non-accepting branch. This one is a non-accepting branch because Q4 is not a final state. So we say that an NFA accepts input string if there is at least one accepting branch. So still this machine accepts the input because there is one accepting branch. So if I have to define what is an accepting branch, right? So if I have to define accepting branch for NFA, it's that two things should be there. Process all the input string. Process whole string. It should not terminate in between. If any branch terminates at intermediate level, you don't say it is accepting branch. So it should be a complete branch, starting from the start state, processing all symbols and reaching. So basically the branch length will be one more than the number of states in the accepting branch will be one more than. So basically if I have to say complete branch, so it will be one more than the number of symbols in the string, those many states will be there in any complete branch. So process whole string, that is, it should be a complete branch without any abrupt termination, right? And next is basically that last state where you reach belongs to F. So for an accepting branch, this is a definition. So given an NFA, assume that you are starting from here, you have all multiple possibilities, from here you have multiple possibilities, from here you have possibility, this goes further, this terminates here, this goes further into two different possibilities, this goes further. and this terminates here, this goes further into two possibilities. I'm just taking a random tree, right? Now, after processing all the inputs, so basically you can see that there are levels. If I have to draw, this is the level. All the branches that are able to reach to this level are complete. Out of this, total how many branches are there? Four. 1, 2, 3, 4 complete branches. Rest of the branches are incomplete. Now out of these four branches, if I say this is R1, this is R2, this is R3, this is R4 different states. So out of R1, R2, R3, R4, if R1 is a final state, R1 becomes an accepting branch. R2 is a final state, R2 becomes an accepting branch. R3 and vice versa. So out of all possible branches, complete branches, if there is at least one accepting branch for a string, you say that that string is acceptable on an FA. In other words, out of this, at least one should belong to F. That's all I'm saying. That out of all possible complete branches, the last state of all these complete branches, at least one should be in the final state. If that is true, then you say that I accept this string. If you really want to take an analogy for it, it is just like Dr. Strange is searching for all possible ways to kill that guy. I don't remember the name of that villain in that movie. And then he realizes that out of all places I am able to reach, I might be killed at different places, it's like termination. But there are multiple possibilities where I remain alive. But, oh good, Thanos, thank you so much. So out of all possibilities, there are some possibilities where I am alive. But out of them, how many are acceptable to me? If I have any acceptable case where I am able to kill Thanos, right? So that is a final state for me. That is an acceptable state for me. So out of all possible places where I don't get killed, I am alive. So I say that is not getting terminated intermediate. I am able to live up to that moment. But if it is acceptable to me or not, it depends on that if my objective is fulfilled. So if any of the final states, if any of the last states after completing processing the whole string, if any of them is acceptable to me, that means there is one possibility at least in which if I proceed, I will be able to reach to a final state. There are several possibilities of processing a string on an FA, but if at least one possibility takes you from the start state, completing the whole processing of the string to some final state, you say that that string is acceptable on an FA. So that's all about accepting a string on an FA, right? So this is how an FA processes. If you see processing of DFA, it is very much sequential, right? It's like that. So that is the difference between a DFA and an FA, and that is why when you write that, just like DFA and if I have to define when a NFA accepts a input, right? So when I say that W is a string and it is actually accepted on N, which is again a five tuple system, Q, sigma, delta N, F and Q, zero. My string is accepted on N if, again, taking the string as, let's say, B1, B2 up to BN, these are the N symbols I have. So again, I have to say that after processing this W on N, I should be able to find a sequence of a state R0, R1 up to Rn such that three conditions, just like DFA, that R0 is Q0. Number 2, here you are writing Ri plus 1 is actually one of the states of Ri when you processed Bi plus 1, right? So this will be true for all values of I equals to 0 to n plus 1. Oh, sorry, n minus 1. And then third is that your Rn should be an element of F. So if you see, this is the differing point than DFA. There you are saying Ri plus 1 is equals to delta. Here you are saying that it should be one of the possibilities in the transition. So it says that again this string will be acceptable if you are able to find a sequence. It is like able to find an accepting branch. So this definition is for accepting branch. Because this ensures that you have processed all the inputs and this ensures that it is reaching to one of the final state. Any questions? So that's all about NFA. Now the question is, certainly it looks like NFA is more powerful than DFA, right? So there are two questions. Is it really powerful in some sense? We will try to see this fact in next class. In addition to that, we will also see that how much powerful. So these two things we're gonna figure it out. So you should also start practicing and designing NFA for different languages. Right, two things we will be seeing in next class, that whether an NFA is more powerful than DFA, in what sense, maybe it can design very quickly, easily and all, but can it design or can it do more than what DFAs can do, because it looks more powerful, right? It is able to see more of a things, it is able to really do more than what DFAs can do, it looks like. So anything, any questions up to this point?